Legumes are giving sugarcane growers a well-needed break. Central Queensland's sugarcane industry produces up to 4 million tonnes of cane annually, most of it from farms that have grown cane crop after cane crop for decades. As a result, root lesion nematodes have become a serious soil-borne pest. However, research has shown legumes such as peanuts make ideal break crops in cane fields because they're unsuitable hosts for these unwanted nematodes.
The real issue was the suite of biology that just lives under a cane monoculture. So by putting the legume in the system, you know, really altered that biology and gave us a lot better ratio of beneficials to pests, particularly nematodes in the soil.
Put into practice, a legume rotation crop could only improve a grower's productivity and profitability. So to ensure research outcomes were adopted and break crops remain a cornerstone of local farming systems, the Coastal Grower Solutions Group demonstrated the value of break crops. The Coastal Group is part of the Northern Grain Region's Grower Solutions Network, initiated by GRDC to better link growers and researchers through local projects.
Yeah, I first got involved with the group, I suppose, in the early days when we were growing soybeans. It was an organised field day between peanut growers and soybean growers. So I went along to the first tour and, we sort of spoke to other growers. And we looked into it and decided we'd give it a go, and they've been a fantastic rotation with our sugarcane.
As well as helping to manage root lesion nematodes, the group's peanut trials also demonstrated peanuts can deliver a 20% boost to cane yields, while growers who have given peanuts a go on their own farms have seen whole farm yield increases of at least 10%.
Seeing the cane perform after the peanuts, even second return or third return in, we've probably picked up another 20 tonne of the hectare minimum over the period.
Being a legume crop, peanuts also added nitrogen to Dean Cayley's soil, which allowed him to reduce his fertiliser costs.
We don't apply any fertiliser when we plant our cane, whereas before we'd probably use up to 300 kilograms to the hectare of a nitrogen-based fertiliser.
And the second row in is where the legume crop was. You can see a marked difference in the vigour of the cane, even 2 years on. It's another probably half a metre taller. In my mind, we can't not grow a legume crop.
Another benefit a peanut break crop has brought to this grower is his farm production has been diversified and his cash flow improved.
We can sort of pick up some more cash in our off season before the crushing starts, and it does the ground the world of wonders, and it allows us too and our fellow to control any weeds that have been left over from sugarcane. We can control that in our peanut crop and then hopefully go back into clean ground for cane for the next 3 to 4 years afterwards.
And rotating crops also means herbicide groups can be rotated, another positive practice more growers should take up, according to Neil Halpin.
It gives us the opportunity to use a different suite of herbicides as well, so better weed control, and it gives us a substantial amount of nitrogen for our plant cane crop afterwards.
These are productive outcomes, and while there are still the bigger issues where a national R&D effort is needed, for those immediate issues that can be handled locally, such as ground truthing the benefits of a legume break crop in cane fields, Grower Solutions Groups would appear to be an appropriate fit.
For the benefits we get out of it, it far outweighs the cost of production of the peanuts.